I talk, but guess what? I back it up.
All right, coming up next, a welterweight matchup between Robbie Lawler and Carlos Condit.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, we are underway with this stand-up-only fight. As we remind you of the rule set here, no grappling or wrestling of any type. Fighters also cannot do any follow-up strikes on the floor. May the best man win, and we are underway. Body kick now by Lawler. Nice jab. Follows it up with a nice right hand.
Just missed with that huge kick.
Lawler gets touched by that leg kick attempt. Oh, he got cracked with the jab there, Joe, and his head is firmly on the center line. The one place it really can't afford to be. He's showing some vulnerability here by leaning right into his opponent's range. Let's see if he can make some adjustments here. Effective strike there by Robbie Lawler.
Huge uppercut misses.
Strong punch there by Connor.
Both men landing in that exchange.
He's hurt.
That was a knee to the liver.
He's back to his feet, but he's hurt.
Head kick.
Under 3 minutes now to go in the round.
Shot. Condit gets caught by the solid uppercut there. He's a hard guy to hit. That one certainly found the target. Just over 2 minutes, round one.
Caught him with a punch. Hit him hard with that
shot. Is true. Now we'll see if he can follow it up.
Body kick, look at that.
A big shot to the head.
Landed some shots. He's teeing off with some vicious shots. Oh, very nice.
Back and forth we go. Condit's strike attempt there is blocked. Damaging strike there.
Oh, he hurt him. Bad. Bad.
Really threw a lot of power into that uppercut, but missed. This fight is dangerously close to being stopped. Really threw everything into that uppercut, but fell short.
Blocks the shot.
Oh, beautiful. Beautiful kick to the body.
That punch will work right through the guard. 10 seconds to go in the round.
He's checking every single one of those.
Round two straight ahead.
So the horn sounds after that round. Big knockdown in that frame. Great round from Condit.
Huge knockdown. It was probably the most important aspect of that round and most likely won the round. Let's see it one more time.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, second round underway.
He's definitely going to want to start this round off fast to try to pick up where he left off. His opponent was in big trouble at the end of that round.
Carlos Condit is an extremely diverse and well-rounded fighter. He's got a long reach. He's very good at mixing his striking up with his grappling. Very unpredictable and a very solid submission game as well.
That one hurt. Big knee to the liver. He's stunned.
He's back to his feet, but he's hurt.
Blocks the shot. All right, so another stiff jab there. Really good use of that weapon, not unlike he did in the previous round. Constantly a moving target. Nice punch there by Law. Oh, he lands a big
left hand. Left hand by Robbie.
Missed that shot.
That bruise on his torso is getting much worse.
He's doing a very nice job protecting his head here.
Good defense there.
Robbie Lawler with some nasty body shots.
No doubt about it, Joe.
But that one really hurt.
The shot lands.
Back up to his feet.
Oh, he might be out. Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. How about that chin?
Oh, man. He is in big trouble here. He's wincing in pain. Hard jab.
Oh, continues to land those.
Oh,
huge right hand.
Oh, he hurt him. Bad. Bad.
He's clearly in pain. He's trying to hang on there, but he is in big trouble.
Excellent timing here to land a huge left for the victory.
Yeah, Joe, just the way he drew it up as he gets the knockout victory here tonight, it's hard to land a strike more flush than he did right there, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming. So he'll see the replay and probably shake his head, but ultimately this is a huge result and a huge win for that fighter here tonight.
Watch this again here.
So a strong candidate for some bonus money there. A huge knockout for him here tonight. Near perfect execution. They'll be talking about this result for some time. Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes in round number two. Declaring the winner by knockout, Ruthless Robbie.
So congratulations are in order to the former UFC welterweight champion, Ruthless Robbie Lawler, still getting it done now, north of 35 years old. He took an extended break from the sport several years ago, and that appears to have paid dividends. Let's not forget, this is a pro career that dates to 2001, and here, two decades later, Ruthless Robbie Lawler still getting it done in the big show. Roller coaster grip, I'm what's major now. Stop, boy, I got hot rods, you could get gangster now. Bang, blow your brains out, see what you thinking about. By associates, I've been scarred, fought and lost with the war. Drop me off around the corner, just let it run, lead a car. Get up the road and turn, this what I thought. From Bossier City, cooking the grocery, you ain't fault. They love the way I talk, my swag, I'm not regular. The fans going mad and my band's on a pedestal. Women in the stands, babe, don't let me get the best of you. Front stage.
stage, Michael Jackson bad, I'm professional. Solo out in public, but I ain't up for no question. Play, I might apply a little pressure, but ain't no wrestling. Sexually aggressive.
All right, coming up next, we get to this lightweight tilt between Conor McGregor and Anthony Showtime Pettis.
You ready?
All right, we are underway with this stand-up only fight as we remind you of the rule set here. No grappling or wrestling of any type. Fighters also cannot do any follow-up strikes on the floor. May the best man win, and we are underway.
That one hurt.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
They have started this fight off with a brawl.
Effective use of the jab there by Conor. Got cracked with the jab there, Joe, and his head is...
Wow!
He's got him hurt here. And just misses.
Oh, he hurt
like
him.
It
he
did stun him a little bit. Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish.
Hard straight punch.
The left hook hits home. Swollen now. How about that shin? Oh!
This could be it. Big straight punch.
Oh, he might be out. Under 3 minutes now to go in what has been a very fast-paced opening round here.
Wow!
Oh! He's out!
Tremendous hook on the button for the win.
Yeah, Joe, just an absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near-perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, saw that little crack of an opening and barged right through it to get the knockout.
Here's a different angle on it. Check out this angle here. Ba-boom!
So a strong candidate for some bonus money there. A huge knockout for him here tonight. Near perfect execution. They'll be talking about this result for some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta's called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 11 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, the Notorious Conor.
Well, what a legacy it has been for the two-division UFC champion, Conor McGregor, and he only adds to it here tonight as he gets his hand raised yet again. Doubt this man at your own peril, ladies and gentlemen. It seems like every time the doubters get on board, Conor finds a way to mute them all, and he does exactly that here tonight. Another massive, massive win for the future UFC Hall of Famer, the Notorious Conor McGregor. Coming up next, we get to a featherweight tilt between Max Holloway and Jose Aldo.
Are you ready? Ready?
All right, round one of this stand-up-only fight is underway. A friendly reminder of the rules set. Not a whole lot of them, but you can't grapple or wrestle at all. And if the fight does hit the canvas, no follow-up strikes permitted on the ground. Trying to establish that jab once again. Aldo gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds.
Caught him with a punch. That one hurt. Both fighters a little bit hesitant to engage, feeling each other out.
Oh, that's a good strike there by Aldo.
Oh! He is really finding a home for those body kicks. Oh, there he connected.
Aldo gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up, Joe.
Good kick to the body by Holloway.
Just over 3 minutes to go.
Great exchanges. Tries a big hook to the head, but misses.
Straight right hand now, just misses. Well, it's one thing to have length, it's another thing to use it.
Oh, he tagged him with the right hand.
Nice combination of strikes there by Holloway.
He's fainting with that punch, showing that punch.
So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are gonna take their toll as this fight goes on. Aldo gets touched by that kick to the body. Beautiful.
Big shot to the liver, he buckles. Whoa, head kick. Shot hurt him bad in the body.
Oh, big right hand there.
Oh, good combination. Hit him hard with that hook. Vicious combination. Beautiful body shot there, too. Body kick, look at that.
How about that shin? Aldo gets hit with a kick. He appears largely unfazed.
Oh, to the body. He's hurt to the body. Oh. Nasty combinations here. Head kick.
Oh, another strike to the body. Not a lot of real estate there, but he found it.
Knee to the body. Big shots. Seconds to go here. Let's see what happens. Oh, very nice.
5 minutes in the books.
And here's a nice kick to the body that lands. And here's another kick to the body. And here's one more perfectly placed kick to the body. Amazing highlights from that round.
Are you ready?
Second round underway.
Starting off this round, you gotta think he's probably still hurt from that last round. He's gonna wanna move and avoid taking damage early. Big shot to the liver, he's stunned. Big power in that hook.
That hook, Joe.
You can tell that body shot hurt him bad.
Oh, big left hook there. Again here, Joe. He is as tough as anybody on the roster, but he looks compromised here. Oh, a huge block there.
Good punch.
Outstanding output on both sides.
Nice jab.
Oh, continuing to work the body with great effect. He's got him hurt here.
Just missed with that huge kick.
Well, he has landed some good shots tonight, Joe.
Oh, this is crazy! Oh, my goodness! He's definitely hurt.
Oh!
He got nailed in the body. He is in big trouble here. Hard straight punch.
And now he lands a combination.
Big shot to the liver. He's hurt bad. Oh! He's stumbling. Oh. He's hurt. Wow! Back to his feet again.
Strike to end this fight. It landed flush. I'm not even sure the opponent wholly saw it coming, and before he could recover, the referee was in to stop the fight. So a huge knockout victory for that fighter here tonight.
Let's look at that from another camera angle.
And here we see it again.
So a seminal moment for him here tonight as the official decision is in. That's where we fall. All right, coming up next, it's a bantamweight matchup between Sugar Sean O'Malley and Frankie Saenz.
You ready to fight? You ready?
All right, so here we go with the stand-up only encounter. We'll see if these guys can play by the rules. Not many rules, but you can't grapple at all. No wrestling of any kind. You also are not permitted to do follow-up strikes on the floor. We are underway. Splits the guard, connects with the punch there, Joe. Just misses with the straight right.
Nice shot.
These guys throwing early. Well, Joe, I know he respects the power coming back, but it looked like he moved right into that kick to the body and his opponent landed it flush. So let's see if he changes up his footwork a little bit and tries to avoid further damage to the midsection moving forward.
Beautiful left hand there.
Oh, he gets tagged there. Nice combination to the head.
Great job landing a series of punches. Nice left kick to the body. Kick lands. Hit him with a jab.
Landing a good series of strikes here.
Excellent defense here. Really good job blocking all those shots coming at his head. Nice leg kick.
Whiffs on the straight right.
1-2.
Nice spinning attack there, and able to land to the body. Beautiful combination there.
And he's looking for that left.
Nice punch there by Sean O'Malley.
He's been landing a lot of uppercuts in this fight. They could be a big factor.
Yeah, I'd agree with you, Joe. As soon as he went to the uppercut early in this fight, he has found a location for it, and he connects with the punch there.
Oh, nice.
And both guys really throwing with authority. Saenz's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. O'Malley gets caught by that straight punch. That'll get his attention. Strong defense there to block the
shot. Nice straight left and a right hand behind it. Looks like he's looking to set up that uppercut.
Oh, nice punch there by Sean O'Malley. Punches in bunches, timing perfect. You better play better defense than that. Oh!
He's in big, big trouble. Just missed with the huge kick.
And beautiful, he lands a big left hand there. And now starting to snap off that jab. 15 seconds. Big roundhouse now, just misses. Round two next.
Beautiful strike here, lands on target. And here's another clean shot that lands. There's a powerful kick to the body. Very impressive striking going on in that round.
All right, round two.
At the end of that round, his opponent was clearly hurt. He's going to look to start this round off fast and try to pick up where he left off.
Not there.
That one hurt.
Straight right hand now, just misses. Tags him with the straight. Nice job there by Frankie Simes. Started to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. How about that chin? Lands to the body.
These guys are swinging.
Constantly a moving target. Simes' strike there is blocked. Nice job by the defense.
Really missed with that right hand.
Well, he has landed some good shots tonight, Joe, but as yet, he has been unable to string together any solid combinations, and that has served to keep his opponent in this fight. So let's see if he can change up the tempo a little bit with his strikes and try to put together a combination that is more damaging to his opponent. Just missed with the leg kick. Well, he was a little bit lackluster in round one. You can't say the same here in this second round. He has really picked up the pace, an uptick in the aggression and the output.
Oh!
He's got him hurt here. Wow.
Oh!
This could be it right here.
Oh, very nice.
Simes gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up.
What a wild exchange!
Good elbow.
Oh! This could be it!
Oh, he missed that kick.
Oh, and he lands another strike to the body. Not a ton of real estate there, but he certainly found it.
Oh!
Oh, he might be out!
He's in trouble, he's in trouble!
Nice job defensively there to get the guard up. Shot is blocked by Simes. All right, 45 seconds now to go on the round.
Tags him.
Simes, his lower jaw looking extremely swollen now.
Huge punches landed by both men.
Now mixing one into the body.
That's stunned him!
He's in big, big, big trouble.
Big body shot.
Counters with a huge right hand. Man, what a round, what a round.
Let's check it out from a different angle. Let's take a look at it from a different angle.
Here we go, 5 minutes remain in the fight. Well, he goes!
He's definitely blocked!
He's hurt! Look at that nasty jab.
Oh! Man has his chin been tested early.
Oh!
Back to his feet again. Amazing. Oh, very nice.
Oh, and he eats a shot.
Well, he just...
Big kick to the nose.
Another knockdown. The
left hook hits home. Getting worse here. Man, is that
good
bleeding.
Combination.
Big body shot.
Vicious combination.
Nice liver shot, Reigns.
You can tell that body shot hurt him bad.
Strikes here in the latter stages of this fight. He's really picked up the pace and landing far more strikes than he did in previous rounds.
Wow, he is getting off some massive kicks.
Yeah. I just had an epiphany, I don't know what it did to me, but I'm hoping the devil doesn't get into me. Still a beast, hoops, it is me, it's finna be off the chain with a brand new delivery. Yeah. Try to get in my way, but feeling the rage, and sit in my vein, and then I blast you to smithereens. Please, I'll be damned if I'm thrown on the back burner. Maniac purge in a rap club with a cat burglar. We committed mad.
Next, it is a featherweight matchup between Conor McGregor and Cub Swanson. Our tale of the tape for this featherweight fight. McGregor is 29, Swanson is 34. McGregor is 1 inch taller, he will have a 4-inch reach advantage. And now with the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, the referee in charge, Eve Loving. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas,
guys, protect yourself at all time, obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now, go back to your corner.
This is a fight that we have been looking forward to for a long time and is about to take place right now. I'm very excited.
Are you ready? Ready?
All right, ready to go with live action here from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. Just missed with the elbow there.
mixes it up with the kicks.
Taps.
Nice kick there by Swanson. Beautiful straight punch there by McGregor.
Good job of timing strikes here. Caught him with a punch.
Rock him, suck him out of the chute here. And he connects there.
Oh, good combination.
Swanson gets absolutely pelted by that head kick. Now mixing one into the body.
Oh, man, with that right leg.
Nice punch there by Swanson there. Well, he ate a pretty big head kick there, Joe. He's got...
Oh, jumping knee! He hurt him with that hook.
Whiffs on the straight right hand.
Oh!
Under 3 minutes now to go on the round.
And he's looking for that left.
Getting the hands going here early.
Fainting.
And both guys really throwing with authority. Kick lands forward there.
He's doing a great job of timing these shots.
Straight right hand now, just missing.
He's taking some shots now. Excellent defense here. Really good job blocking all those shots coming at his head.
Kick to the body by McGregor. Oh, tags him nicely with that uppercut, Joe.
Oh!
Well, he just hasn't been efficient with...
Oh, he tagged him. He tagged him with the right hand.
Swanson gets caught with that punch. His chin is held up thus far. Got to shore up the defense here, though. Try to establish that jab. Wow! And just like that, the fight is over.
Vicious uppercut lands on the button.
Well, Joe, you knew if he landed that weapon repeatedly, it could be a short night for his opponent. But that was just one perfectly placed strike that his opponent candidly didn't even see coming. It landed flush, and the rest, as they say, is history. Big knockout win for him here tonight.
Picture perfect, right on the point of the chin.
Let's take a closer look at that from a different angle. Here we see it again.
Bam!
90. All right, we go back inside the octagon.
Let me talk to you for just a quick moment, cause I see that you are in me. You wanna drink to get drunk, so you drank on my drink, but I'd rather roll with you. Since your intentions are not my dimensions, I think that it's time you should leave. Okay. And if you don't mind, hop off my line, yeah. Cause I am inclined to find a new dog.
Said she love dark meat, filet mignon. If you late with Sean, she gon' stay till morning. Most likely, give a great A performance. No waste, but the cake's enormous. Really ass mouth, but her face is gorgeous. She gon' make a playboy pay her mortgage. Escape in the rape.
All right, coming up next is a light heavyweight matchup between the Iceman, Chuck Liddell, and John Volante. And now our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight fight.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
We are underway.
Looking to avoid that left hand.
Landed that one.
Oh! Huge left shot.
Left hand.
This fight is dangerously close to being
stopped. Oh, he is up, but man, is he hurt.
A finish could come here at any time. This is crazy. Oh, my goodness.
While the body was wide open, his opponent took advantage. Kick to the body, lands flush. He's going to have to make some adjustments here moving forward. Slips that left hand. How good is that jab by John Volante? How about that chin?
Looking for the left hook.
He just tagged him with that uppercut. He's got to be careful not to run into things, though.
Kick to the body by the former football standout, John Volante.
Big kick, but miss.
No, the left leg goes high.
Well, the strike lands, but he is visibly fatigued, Joe, and as such, not doing a whole lot of damage at this point in the fight. Oh, nice hook by Chuck Liddell.
Beautiful kick to the body.
Uppercut there, blocked by Chuck Liddell. Very nice leg kick there by Vellante. Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
He got tagged there.
Now he's got over-under, Joe.
Good uppercut.
Well, he split the guard beautifully there. Another uppercut landed by the Iceman.
And from here, transitions to the Muay Thai clinch. He's got the plum here.
Nice big knee! Big knee! He's got him hurt here. All right, so we are underway with this highly anticipated stand-up only clash. So these ladies got to play by the rules here tonight. No grappling whatsoever. Jiu-jitsu fighters need not apply. You also can't do any follow-up strikes on the floor. Let's see who the last woman standing will be. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Albu gets caught by that straight punch. Beautifully landed by the opposition.
That one hurt.
Nice punch there by Yeon Jae-chan. Well, she ate that hook shot like a champion. Joe, but she's got to be careful moving into her opponent's range. Largely unguarded, she has been susceptible early. We'll see if she can adjust. She lands the straight punch here. Albu gets hit by that leg kick, so maybe that one gets her attention. Oh! Oh, how clean is that jab by Albu?
Really missed with that right hand.
Yeon Jaicek gets hit with a kick. That one appeared to land flush. Oh!
Oh! Misses a huge hook to the head.
She blocked the punch. Nice kick there by Albu. Getting the hands going here. Whoa!
This could be it right here. Vicious combinations. Nice leg kick.
Under 2 minutes to go. What a fight we got going on here.
Huge left shot.
How good is that left hand, Joe?
Tries a big hook to the head, but misses.
Albu's leg appears to be hurt here, Joe. That is an obvious limp.
Oh!
Big hand!
This could be it! Here's a nice inside leg kick.
Under a minute now to go.
And here another big shot lands and another knockdown. And here another clean shot lands and another knockdown. Incredible round with several moments where it looked like it might be over.
All right, round two. Able to check the high kick. She has landed some very significant strikes, but as yet, she has still been unable to string together anything in terms of a solid combination. And it is going to take strikes in bunches to get an opponent of this caliber out of there. Let's see where she goes from here. Oh, caught her with the head kick. Wow!
This could be it! Tremendous hook, landed flush for the victory.
Yeah, that was just a beautiful shot by her there to end the fight. I'm not sure she could have drawn it up any better than it played out here tonight. She lands the seminal blow there midway through the round. I'm not even sure her opponent saw it coming. So big, big knockout win for her here tonight.
Let's see it one more time. Look at the power in this hook as it lands for the knockout. Here we see it again. Bam!
The official decision is in. Here's...
Let me give him a friendly reminder. Y'all already know that y'all gotta talk every single time I come here. Now I gotta do it. Yes, I gotta do it, and I gotta kill him, and I gotta hit him. You see, no one gotta beat him stupid. Only got 41 seconds as a given. Every single bitch, I gotta use it. So I'm gonna do it, and I can't get the microphone, and I make him lose it. And I make him jump in the back. She in the back of the truck, little mommy wanna fuck, and she really wanna fuck. When I finish with it, then we go in the back of the club, and we do this shit again, man. Pronto. Bitty better do booty to beat it like a bongo. Banging on the like a name Alonzo. Head game crazy to make it a head honcho. Man, cause I took his bitch, and I'm gonna think he macho.
It is a light heavyweight matchup between Mauricio Shogun Hua and Vitor Belfort. And now our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight fight. Belfort is 4 years his senior, Hua. Dateline, Las Vegas, Nevada. No better place to be on fight night. We are underway here at the T-Mobile Arena. That strike will count. Blocks the shot.
Both guys have proved to be dangerous in the opening seconds of this fight.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Swing and a miss with that straight left hand. Belfort gets caught by the inside kick.
And a left hand behind it. That one hurt.
Well, he's playing with fire here, Joe. He continues to be vulnerable to that jab by almost leaning into it right into his opponent's range. Got to find a way to move those feet and ultimately get that head off of the center line.
Missed the mark.
Pretty good straight punch there. Oh!
This could be it right here.
With that right hand.
He's doing a great job blocking these shots. Blocking all the shots coming towards his head.
Under 3 minutes now to go on the round. That landed. Back and forth we go. Winding it up on the right there to no avail.
He got tagged there.
Shot is blocked there by Shogun Hua. How about that shin?
And another one, he's in trouble. Oh, he's going for it here.
Oh. Huge shots there.
Big left hand.
Belfort gets up again here, Joe. That's the good news. Bad news is he looks hurt. I'm not sure how long he's going to be able to survive.
Powerful leg kick. He's hurt again. Oh, he's getting hit. Oh, very nice. This fight is dangerously close to being stopped.
Both of these guys going all out. High action fight here.
Oh, solid jab. Oh, nice right hand. He hurt him. Oh!
And just like that, the fight is over.
He threw an incredibly large volume of strikes, but this last one was the big one that landed for the knockout.
Yeah, Joe, just an absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near-perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, saw that little crack of an opening and barged right through it to get the knockout.
Let's see if we get a better look at that from this angle. Look at this. Bang.
So a seminal moment for him here tonight as Bruce Buffer has the official decision. Coming up next, a UFC bantamweight division fight. Our tale of the tape for this bantamweight fight. Eduardo is 20 years the elder. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the official introductions, we go inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing at 135 pounds. Riding out of Chicago.
You ready? You ready?
We are underway. Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. Opens with the left hand and lands flush. Straight right hand, no good. Opens with the left hand and lands flush.
He's doing a very good job of parrying and blocking all the shots that are coming towards his left.
Grips the body there. Well, he left his body wide open there for that hook shot, Joe, and he paid for it. He is leaning in. I know he's got the guard high, but that means the body is exposed, and the opposition took full advantage there. And Eduardo gets hit with a kick. That one appeared to land flush. Overhand left, swing and a miss. Lands a punch. Blocks the shot. Nice body kick there.
Those punches are very hard.
Eduardo's uppercut is blocked. Looked like for a minute he had a window there. It closed quickly. Oh, a lot of volume here. Good series of strikes there. Oh. That one appeared to stun him. Oh!
He's got to be careful here. Hit him hard with that hook. Big straight punch. Oh, very nice.
Just out of range with that right hand. Nice straight there by Eduardo. Oh, that cut has really opened up now, Joe.
Oh, he's hurt.
And
oh,
just like that, the fight is over.
Big roundhouse kick KO for the victory.
Indeed, Joe, that was a tremendous kick to end the fight tonight. Caught the opponent flush with full force and extension. And frankly, there was no chance after that. The fight was over as soon as that one made contact. Certainly one for the highlight reel here tonight.
We can see it from a different angle here. Look at the power in this roundhouse kick. And when it lands, the fight is done. And let's see that again. Boom! Right on the money.
So a huge result and a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the big knock. Let's get it to Bruce Buffer to make it a fit.
Not hurt anybody in the same club that used to turf everybody. I put in 25 hours out, outworked everybody. Turned down big money, I know my worth. I'm not anybody, don't let them hold you down. I'm from the bottom, that's where they hold you down. Sink or swim, don't you drown. I'm with my circle, let's go.
Coming up next, a UFC bantamweight tilt. And now our tale of the tape for this bantamweight fight. Eduardo is 20 years the elder. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. And now one more time for the official introductions. Here's Bruce Buffer.
You ready?
All right, ready to go with live action here from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. There. Doubling up on the jab. These guys throwing early.
Oh, turning side kick. Very nice. That one hurt. Good shot. Caught that one on the forearm. The kick lands.
Well, he eats a punch to the head there, Joe, and he would be wise to get his head off of that center line. It's almost as if he's moving straight into that punch.
Caught him with a punch.
Wow. That one appeared to stun him. Back to the feet.
Hit him hard with that hook
to the chin.
Misses a huge hook to the head. Body kick, look at that.
Oh, big left. Beautiful sequence of strikes there. Nice combination.
He just landed an outstanding leg kick. He's back to his feet, but he's hurt.
Shot blocked by Edwardo.
Huge shot from the hook. Hard straight punch.
Just misses with this straight right.
He tagged him. Oh. Straight punch for the knockout victory.
Yeah, Joe, beautiful shot. Bruce Buffer is in the octagon. Coming up next, it's a welterweight bout between Donald Cerrone and Tom Breeze. Our tale of the tape for this highly anticipated welterweight fight. Cerrone is 8 years his senior. The reach is
idle. You ready to fight? You ready?
Well, good to have you with us, and right on time, I might add, as we get underway here at the O2 Arena in London, England. Opens with the inside leg kick. Cerrone gets caught with that punch. He's treading water now. Got to find a way to move those feet.
He tagged him with that right hand.
Edge of your seat action as expected so far.
Oh, nice body shot.
He's doing a great job of being unpredictable and mixing things up here.
Well, he got his head snapped back by that straight hand there, and he's shown a vulnerability tonight by leaning right into that punch as he tries to set up his own offense. May want to focus on some defense here moving forward.
Oh, that left hook caught
him. Lands a nice 1-2.
This could be it right here.
Oh, he might be out.
Oh!
Back and forth we go. A big right hand. Slip.
Oh, he's hurt. He's hurt. Vicious combinations.
Big
body
shot.
Body shot there, too. Hard straight punch.
Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot.
Oh, very nice.
Trying to establish that jab once again.
Oh, he hurt him. He clipped him.
He's got him hurt here.
Huge uppercut misses.
Nice punch by Cowboy Cerrone.
Look at this.
Oh, straight right.
Landed a hard kick for the knockout.
I should say so. A tremendous kick to end that fight tonight. Caught his opponent flush, full force, full extension, and he had no chance to stay in this fight. Fight was over as soon as that kick made flush contact. All right, let's get it inside of Bruce Buffer.